Now, in order to derive a generalized relation which will have all the terms, like a monopole term as well as a dipole, a quadrupole, octuple, and so on, we will consider a irregular shape with some charge distribution, and then in this charge distribution we are having this a point, and in this charge distribution we are considering a volume element, a fraction of volume element, which is d tau prime. Is, you know, that for the source coordinates we are using the prime to identify them. So the from this point to the source we are having the distance is r prime, and then from this point to the observation point we are having the distance is r, while as usual from the source to the observation point we are having the tilted r there. Then I can write for this charge distribution the potential is equal to V of r, which is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught in integral 1 over tilted r in rho of r prime d tau prime. So this is rho d tau is basically the charge, and then charge over r, and is its irregular shape, so we will have to do the integration in order to find the total charge on this charge distribution. So we go on with this relation and we will utilize the previous results. This is theta prime, so from here I can write that this tilted r square is equal, this r square is equal to this r square plus this r square plus r prime squared minus 2 times the r in r prime, r in r prime in cos of the angle between r in r prime. So theta is the angle, theta prime I will write is theta prime. It's the angle between r and r prime. So we have this thing, and let me now write that relation is r squared is equal, if I take this r square is common, then I am left with 1 plus and then r prime over r, and this will be squared minus 2 and r prime over r, and this is cos of theta, because here when this is divided by r square, so it will come out to be r prime or r square, one r will cancel here, so r prime or r will come in cos of the angle. So here it is this relation cos theta prime, and now if I write this thing is this, I take a square root on this side as well as on this side, then it will become tilted r, and this is r, and this whole will become power 1 over 2. So I can write this is, this implies the tilted r will come out to be r and 1 plus, let's say I just simply write this thing is 1 plus epsilon. So 1 plus epsilon means power 1 over 2, so this is 1, so this whole term will come out to be equal to epsilon. So I can write that epsilon is basically equal or defined is this. I am doing just to not write these all things again and again, because in the coming expansion the powers will come in, and then it will become more difficult to write all those things again and again. So I am just supposing this thing equal to epsilon. So epsilon is equal to r over r prime, r prime over r. I further simplify this one. If I take r prime or r common from this one, then this is r prime or r, so it will come out to be r prime over r minus 2 and cos of theta. So this is our, and this will be theta prime. So this is our epsilon equal to this thing, and now I can apply the further calculations here. So this is what will be 1 over r, because here I am having 1 over r. So 1 over r will come out to be 1 over r, and this 1 plus epsilon, its power is 1 over 2, so it will become minus 1 over 2. As I know that epsilon is very, very less than 1, because I am considering the large distances. What will happen when r will be very, very greater than this r prime? So r prime over r, this will become very, very less. So we are having the epsilon very, very less, and we will utilize the binomial expansion, and this time we will go for higher terms. So this will come out to be equal to 1 over r will be equal to 1 over r, and this term will be 1 over r, and then 1 plus nx. So 1 plus nx, it will come out to be 1 minus n is half, and then epsilon, and then n into n minus 1, and divide by 2 factorial, and the binomial expansion, you know, I will not need to repeat this thing. So I will write the results here in 3 over 8 then, and epsilon square plus this one alternative plus minus will change, so this one will be minus, this one is minus, and 5 over 16 and epsilon cube, and then the next term will be plus, and so on. So there are other terms, but I'm just limiting myself to these many terms. And now I will put the epsilon value, because now I have written this thing in this form. So I've just put the value of the epsilon in order to do further simplification. So I can write 1 over r, and then I will have to use the square bracket here, and 1 minus 1 over 2, and then for the epsilon I will write this one. This is r prime over r, and r prime over r minus 2 cos theta prime, and similarly plus 3 over 8, and it will be epsilon square. So I will write the epsilon square, and for the epsilon square it will come out to be r prime over r and squared, while this will be r prime over r minus 2 cos theta prime, and this will also become square, then minus 5 over 16 and epsilon cube, so r prime over r whole cube, and r prime over r minus 2 cos theta prime cube, and plus there are other terms as well. So we have put the value of epsilon, and now from this relation I will have to take something common here, and then 1 over r, delta r is equal, I take 1 over r here, means this is it is, and then from this one, 1 and minus 2 here. So if I look here, then this will multiply with this one. So it will become minus 1 over 2 r prime over r, and then these will become squared. So, and the next term will be minus 1 over 2 r prime over r, and 2 will cancel and cos theta prime. So I write this one earlier. So it will be 1 plus this term I write earlier. So minus 2, they will cancel, and we will have plus and r prime over r, and this is here cos theta prime. Similarly, plus this one. Now here, this is 1 over 2 and r square over r prime square. If I look at this term, r prime square, this is square term. So because I am just differentiating it with respect to r and r prime, so one square is coming here and one square is coming here. But with this one, if I go, then this is squared, this is becoming cube, and this square is with cos square theta prime is the r square term. So I will combine these two here, and then if I look here, the cube terms means this term is being combined with this one. Like here, let me differentiate here. Like this term came first. This term came first. While here this is squared, so the squared term is basically connecting with this one, and then it connects with this one. Similarly, this term is cube, is becoming cube. So this cube will be then connected with this one, because cube here, and this will multiply and it will give R4. So it is just, you can say, the shuffling between them are, if for example we do multiply them, and then we take common from there. So I am writing this in date form in order to save some steps here. So r prime, I will be discussing each, means discussing them date from where this term comes in. So minus this and this, it is r and r prime. So I am writing plus, I am writing this thing is minus 1 over 2 and this, so this is r prime over r cos theta prime, which has come just from multiplication of this one with this one, and plus r prime over r, and this is now squared, so it means it is this term. And further, is this is minus term, so I will write this later. And the next square term is this one, so it is minus here, so I will write this one first, and this will come out to be like this, that r prime over r and 3 cos square theta. Because here, if I look over here, then what this will become, this will be, is it a square, so this will be just 2 and the square of this one, so 4 cos square theta, and 4 will simplify with this one as well, so only 3 will remain. 1 over 2 from here, this has become 1 over 2 because it will be 4, and this will become 2, so 2 I am taking out, and then it will be minus 3 cos square theta. I am writing in this form 3 cos square theta prime, and then minus 1 of this one. So I have to take 1 over 2 as common, and then this whole has been divided by 2, because this is this by 2 is 1 over 2 is common from there. I can write 1 over 2 here as well, but I want to keep a certain structure, and that structure is important. So the next is 5, this will be plus an r prime over r, and this is whole cube. And look here, where are the cube terms coming? There is no cube term coming in here. The cube term 1 is here, because this is r prime square and this is r prime. So cube term is coming in here. 1 term is here, and the next term is this end with this one. So we are having again 2 here. So this is 5 cos cube theta prime, 5 cos cube theta prime, and minus. Now how this one become 5 cos cube? Because 5 is here, this will become 8, and this is cube. So 8 cos cube, 8 will simplify with this one, and 1 over 2 will survive here. So I will have 1 over 2 means it whole will be divided by 2. 5 times cos cube theta prime, and then minus this one, this term which is coming in here, this one, the cube term here. This is 3 over 8. So 3 over 8 is, we have 8 from there. So this is 3 over 8 here, and what this will become 2, and then we have 3 cos theta prime, 3 cos theta prime here, and minus 3 cos theta prime, and this whole will be divided by 2 is like this, because 2 has been taken as common. Only is 5 survives here, 3 will survive here, and we have minus 3 cos theta prime plus, and there are some other terms as well. Now the purpose of writing this thing